Hi everyone, and welcome to class. Today I want to talk about the most important tool I have on the bench. Out of all the tools I have in my shop, not only just on the bench, but hanging out on the walls, I've got a lot of tools. Out of all of those, the most important tool I have is this little guy right here. It's my feeler gauge. And today I want to show you how important this tool is, how you use it, and most importantly, how you can make your own really cheap. Next time anybody has a birthday and they get one of their balloons, save it. You know how it gets all out of air or out of helium? Save that because this can become a world supply of feeler gauges. Here's what we're going to do. We're going to take a razor blade or a knife or something like that and cut it open. We're going to get rid of this bottom section here that's got all that because it's too thick. So we're just going to take our bag, we're going to tear this thing open. We're worried about this single ply of Mylar. You're going to take your razor blade and a ruler. And I want about a 2-inch long piece of Mylar. So I'm just going to come up here and take 2-inch long cut on my ruler. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to slide this back just a little bit. So I've got about 2.5 millimeters or about 1/8 of an inch of material sticking out there. I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to take a 2-inch cut. I'm going to make several of those because if I'm here and I've got this work, going to this work, you might as well get ready for the next couple times you're going to want to replace the material of your feeler gauge because it does start to wear out over time. So I'm just going to make several cuts in along here. Now that I've got several of these, I'm going to come back in above all of those cuts that I just made and cut myself out a big chunk so that they all stay together. So now I've got this little jobbies out here like this hanging off, but they're all going to hang out. Now, save this part. This part, save it. Fold it up, throw it in your drawer, share it with your entire district because that's enough material to last me the rest of my life, let alone how many people you can take care of with just one used Mylar balloon. All right, the next thing we're going to do is we're going to take all these guys here, and I'm going to cut off one of these guys here. And I'm going to come to the end of this piece, and I'm going to just cut a point into it. So I'm just going to go at the angle and cut a little bit of a point into that feeler gauge so I've got it. The next piece of a feeler gauge that you need is really hard to come by. You need a pencil. And I don't care if it's a number 2 pencil or a mechanical pencil. I don't care if it's a matchstick. I don't care if it's a piece of dowel. It doesn't matter what it is. The next thing we do then is we take this material. You can tape this or super glue this onto anything you want. So let's take a little bit of super glue here on this one today. Take a little bit of super glue onto the end of your pencil. And take your feeler gauge material and stick that on there. Now, super glue is going to take just a second to dry out. The other thing you can do is use just some regular scotch tape. Get a hold of your feeler gauge material and tape it onto your pencil like so. So, there you've got it. This entire thing right here with this little piece of material sticking off of it is your feeler gauge. What we do with the feeler gauge is we actually use it in order to determine whether a pad is open or closed and whether it's sealing and working or if it's leaking air and the instrument doesn't work. The way we use this is we take the instrument itself and let's take this key here. We simply slide the feeler gauge in underneath the pad and close it down lightly. We're not trying to squeeze it. I'm not worried about how manly strong I am here. This is the time where you get to use delicate touch. So I'm going to delicately close the key to where it just touches, where I feel it hit the very first time, not where I can squeeze it to, but just the first delicate touch I can get. And then you see my grip on my pencil? I barely have a hold of this thing. I'm going to close that up and I'm going to give it a little bit of a tug. Feel that? See that tug? See how I can actually pull this? The material is loose and I can pull that material tight. I want to feel that tug all the way around the pad. Now I want to make sure that the feeler gauge material is just inside the tone hole. I don't want this to come across two pieces of the tone hole like this. I just want the tip of it inside. That way I'm only feeling one part of the hole. given time. And then I simply take this around and feel it. Now, as I'm playing with this, I'm seeing how big this feeler gauge is. This is actually a little too wide for me. I'm going to come in here and trim this guy thinner and pull it off my pencil. So now I've got my feeler gauge material cut down a little bit thinner, so I'm using and feeling a smaller gap. So I can feel this all the way around the tone hole. Make sure that the pad is sealing. If it's not sealing, what's going to happen is you're going to feel a tug over on this side. And on this side, your feeler gauge is just going to come right straight out. See how I can actually move this in and out? You're going to feel that there's no pressure right there at all, but there is pressure here. This is what tells you what's loose and what's not. So where this side of the key is tight, and this side is loose and it has no grip at all, I know that this key needs to be bent back this direction. So you can just grab a pair of pliers, grab a hold of that key, try to move it back, use your feeler gauge to feel for some pressure. I have a lot of pressure over here and very little over on this side, so I know I need to keep going just a little bit. I'm going for is equal pressure all the way around the tone hole. The other thing that a feeler gauge does is helps us determine whether keys are closing in tandem. So I've got this guy closing and I've got this guy loose. I don't have any grip in that. Where this one, I've got it closing and I've got a little bit of tug here, but both of those are a little loose. That one's tight. That one's loose. So what I know I need to do is I need to screw down on all of these screws here. I'm only going to do one at a time. You can see how small of a movement that was. Check out my video on flute adjustments to learn more about what I'm doing here. But your feeler gauge allows me to feel that both of those keys are closing correctly. Now I can move on to the next one and pay attention to how much I need to move this one. Folks, that is all there is to building your own feeler gauge. You could get an old balloon, a pencil, and some tape, stick that bad boy on there, and you've got yourself a feeler gauge. It allows you to start seeing if your pads are closing together, or if that key has been bent and sealing, hitting one side, not the other side, and needs to be moved around a little bit. If you have any questions on how to repair your own instrument, go over to repairmasterclass.com, scroll on down on the homepage to the emergency repair guide, and get your free copy of this emergency repair guide. In it, you're going to find a bunch of different tips and tricks and an ever-growing library of new videos that are coming out soon and detailed explanations of how to do repairs yourself. Guys, if you're not here, join me every Tuesday. I go live on Zoom, so you can come in and answer questions and ask me anything you want on repairing your own inventory. If you don't have a link to that, go to repairmasterclass.com, scroll on down the homepage, and click on the Join Me Live button, and get the link to come join me live on Zoom every Tuesday. We'll see you next week. Use a lighter or some fire, whatever you